The goal of this game is for children to figure out what card is missing from a line of cards. We'll start out using the 1 through 5 count and see cards, but you can add higher cards as kids get more experience. The first thing to do is to shuffle the cards and lay them out on the table. Then ask the children to put the cards in order from least to greatest. This is the first step in many of our count and see card games, because it lets you get a glimpse at children's mathematical thinking. Like, can they put the cards in order? Or are there some numbers that they still need practice with? You can notice which numbers they move first, whether they're counting the dots, or if they recognize the written numerals. Once the cards are in order, I'll say, "Okay, close your eyes," and then I'll remove one of the cards. Then I'll say, "Open your eyes. What's the missing card?" Figuring out which card is missing helps kids' sense of number order, or knowing which numbers come before and which numbers come after a given number. Once they identify the missing card, I'll say, "Yeah, it is 4. How did you know it was 4? And I'm trying to figure out if they counted up from 1, or maybe they knew what number comes after 3. Then I'll try to reinforce the idea of number order by saying, "Yeah, 4 comes after 3 and before 5. And we'll keep playing as long as the children are interested. In this game, children are getting a lot of practice with number order and comparing quantities, meaning that they're learning what numbers come before and after other numbers, as well as what numbers are more than and less than other numbers. This develops children's number sense, which makes it easier for them to think and talk about numbers and to build their understanding of more complex math ideas like addition and subtraction later on.